This is me. The moment I realize that I have work tomorrow. If you guys do not know, Fridays are usually the most busiest days at my workplace. And honestly, it gets to a certain point when I'm just like, yo, the traveling, the distance, everything to do with this job can be overwhelming. I'm struggling to adapt. I'm struggling to get used to the surroundings and everything. It's been a struggle. And I've just realized that my boss is watching this video. What is good? What is really good, my people? It is UK. Chocolate brother, dr.blick, the darkest man around. Today, guys, this will be a likes and dislikes video on my workplace. If you guys do not know, I work at a restaurant. I'm gonna name the restaurant at the end of the video. So if you guys are in London area, I'll give you the restaurant and boom, come down and come and get some nice Caribbean, African, Latin food, man. The food is legit, cheeks worthy. But we're gonna do a likes and dislikes video on, I wouldn't say the restaurant, I would say restaurants in general, because I feel like the concept applies to pretty much every restaurant you work at. It's work, and if you worked at one place, the logic for the most part applies in the same place, especially if it's the same type of job. So if there's been a time for you guys to get that fried chicken and get that glorious ass Kool-Aid, now is the perfect time, because the UK chocolate brother will be going ham on this video. So without further ado, let me just get with it. So let's start off with the likes. So one of the first things I want to mention is the people. The people I work with personally are really nice. When you're on their good side, everything is Gucci. When you're on their bad side, or when you do something wrong, I'm gonna leave that for the dislike section. So if my boss is watching this, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, bro. I gotta be honest, man. This is for entertainment purposes. This is for comedic purposes. But overall, you guys are nice, man. You guys treat me good. And that's what it's all about. You're on a team with whoever you're working with. You want to be treated great. You want to be treated like you're one of the people, you know. You're one of the crew members. And honestly, for the most part, they do that. So one of the major things that people love about working in a restaurant, especially if you like the food, is the discounts. Lord have mercy. The discounts is really cheeks worthy. Like, the food there is so good. I remember when I went there for my trial shift, I took back the spicy food, and I was just like, okay, you guys say spicy, man. My dad makes spicy food, and when he makes spicy food, you get a good sweat on, man. You be sweating, you be dripping buckets, you be questioning life, like, why is this so damn hot and it's cold at the same time? Like, what kind of spices did my dad put in this, man? You be questioning that all at once, and when it comes down to that food I ate, it was hot, man. It was fiery hot. I was surprised. I was like, yo, this is actually competing with my dad's food. Lord have mercy. Like, yo, she wasn't kidding when she said that it's gonna be hot when it's spicy. And yeah, they don't play with that. But the food was good. The chicken was, if you guys have been subscribed to this channel, you guys know I love me some chicken. So when I bit into that chicken, man, have you ever ate chicken that is so good that you don't want it to finish? Have you ate chicken that is so good that you don't want to be full? Have you ever ate chicken that is so good that, yeah, you've seen that one episode of SpongeBob where King Neptune eats the burger and the regurgitates it back into his original form just to try it a second time?
Give me that. Why, it tastes so good. I think I'd like to try it a second time.
That's how I felt, even though that's kind of nasty, but that's how I felt when I dived my mouth into that chicken. Lord have mercy, man. That chicken was so damn good. So one of the major things is the discount, you know what I'm saying? Is the discount. So one thing I like about this job is flexibility. Obviously, there's going to be some days that you don't want to work. There's going to be some holidays that you don't want to work. There's going to be some amount of hours you don't want to work. Me, when I decided to get a job, the whole aim of me getting a job was it being part-time, you know, not working a full shift. Because if I work a full shift, then my plan of making videos goes down the drain. My aim of becoming a football player goes down the drain, because at the end of the day, man, I need time to train, I need time to record, and I need time to edit. And this job gives me a great amount of flexibility. As long as I work on some of the busy days, I'm Gucci. And I don't mind working on Fridays. I don't mind working on Sundays. As long as I'm able to get home, because if you guys do not know, I currently do not own a car. And that makes me a kind of a broke ass nigga. But life is a struggle. And you gotta rack up the peas you got. And then hopefully later down the line, when I'm looking back on this video, I got money to show for. Like Floyd Mayweather said.
Rain all day long. My name is Floyd. My name is Floyd. My name is Money Mayweather. My name is Floyd. My name is Floyd. My name is Money Mayweather.
But yeah, honestly. Wait, hold up. Pause the damn video. I gotta say this. Some of the girls that be coming in, Lord have mercy, they be looking real good. They be looking real good. But unfortunately, they're coming in with their boyfriends. And it sucks, man. It sucks. But that's another positive. I don't even know if it's a positive or negative. I just felt the need to mention it, my nigga. The flexibility of the times is great. And it fits me perfectly. On to the dislikes. Lord have mercy, man. If my manager slash boss is watching this, I'm sorry. Like, legit, man. This is for entertainment purposes. It's all fun and games. So please, 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 I beg of you, don't take this person. Lord, let's break this down. I might do this in one sitting instead of breaking it down into sections. Nah, I'm gonna break it down into sections. But yeah, let's start. Being the new guy. Being the new guy at a workplace is so much different than being the new guy at school. When you're the new guy at school, everybody wants to be your friend. You feel like you're the shit. You feel like you're the man. You feel like you're the guy with all the sauce. You know what I mean? You feel like you're the guy with all the sauce. And being the new guy at work, no, you're just not that dude. You run all over the place. You got people telling you what to do. And when I mean what to do, I don't mean being told what to do is a bad thing. I mean being told what to do in the sense that a good example is this. Yeah, one of my managers told me to stay at the front because there's a back place, they got a little bar where they serve all the drinks, all that stuff. One of my managers asked me to stay at the front, so I was staying at the front. Another dude that's one of the little, like, that's a co-worker, is like, yo, can you help me with something? I'm like, yo, what is it, man? Yo, can you just wash all these plates? Then after that, I want you to get those other plates. So yeah, wash that too. And after that, just let me know if you got any problems. And yeah, that's about it. I'm just like, nigga, what are you doing? Like, legit, what are you doing? Like, legit, what are you doing? Like, I do all this stuff, but what do you do? And I'm just like, okay. And then my manager's like, yo, why did you go there? I told you to stay in the front. I was like, this dude asked me to do this thing, but you asked me to do this thing, and my head is spinning around in circles. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's all over the place. I don't know whether to go left. I don't know whether to go right. I don't know whether to go back. I don't know whether to go front. I generally do not know. I'm confused. So, being the new guy, you have a lot of people that love to tell you what to do when, in theory, they're not really supposed to do that. Sometimes they have the ability to do that. And me, personally, I don't mind, but the issue with that is when one person is telling me to do one thing and another person is telling me to do one thing, it kind of gets confusing. And for me personally, if I'm not learning one thing all the way through and I'm learning a bit of this and a bit of this and a bit of this and a bit of this, it's kind of hard because I'm one of those people, I'm a visual learner. So I got to see it and then I got to repeat it again and again and again and again and again. That's the best way I learn. But if you put me in a situation when I'm not able to repeat it, I do it once in a while, I do it bit by bit, I don't really learn anything. I'm kind of taking in information in one ear, and then the information's going out the other ear, you know? And that's not what I want, you know? And being a new guy, you get that issue, and it happens a lot. And yeah, and that's pretty much one of the negatives about working in that place. So the final con, and you guys may be wondering, there's only two. And the reason why there's only two, because I'm looking at my points, I pretty much broke down majority of the points. I pretty much broke down majority of the points in the first one, so I only got one point that's left, and the point that is left is making mistakes. And me, I'm one of those people, I'm a proud person, not overly proud. I'm open to learn, but I hate making mistakes. I hate doing stuff wrong. It don't sit right with me. And to a certain extent, when I'm asking for help and stuff, people's like, yo, you don't know this already? I need you to know this, my nigga. I'm just like, yo, it's been 3 days. I've only been here for 3 days. And you expect me to know the whole menu like the back of my hand? I'm trying. I'm trying. So when it comes to that, it does get to situations where things are all hectic. So a lot of people expect you to know things like that, you know, and you're not always going to be able to know things off the cuff. You're not always going to be able to know things like the back of your hand. Some people need time and some people pick it up as you go along. For me, a guy that's never worked at a restaurant, I'm learning everything from scratch. So I'm taking time to embed all the knowledge in, taking time to learn the menu, which I still don't know. And I should be revising the menu right now. And Lord have mercy. But anyways, in conclusion, you guys may be wondering, do I like my job? And the answer is Yeah, I love it. I love my job. I love it so much.
Like that's ever gonna happen. Oh, I love it.
We'll do seriousness, man. Obviously, when you work, especially if it's not your dream job, even if it's your dream job, there's always pros and cons to working at a restaurant, you know? Some restaurants are gonna treat you nicer than others, and some restaurants just treat you like utter shit. It's not even the base. It's pure doo-doo. You know what I'm saying? But as a whole, guys, I want to know what you guys think about this. If you want to know the name of the restaurant is called Guanabana. It's in Camden. So I'm going to post some images for the food. I'm giving them self-promotion, which I don't really like to do. But hey, Guanabana's there. And if you go in on the right days, like Fridays, you will see me there. Working. Probably struggling to get things right, but hey. You learn from mistakes, you know, you learn from mistakes. But as a whole, guys, I want to know what you guys think about this. Leave your thoughts and opinions down in the comment section below. This has been your UK Chocolate Brother, Dr. Blick, the darkest man around. And it is time for me to put down that fried chicken and the Kool-Aid and wrap up this video. So, please comment and subscribe. I know I say this all the time, but at the end of the day, I'm just saying. Please leave a like rating, enjoy this video, and yeah, this black man from the UK will catch you in the next one.